The following is a class on the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chapter 20, Text 110 and 111, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 17, 1975, in Bombay, India.
Josna Vistarina Gatha Parasra Brahmana Shakti Tathidam Akilam Jagat. We are discussing this part last Sunday night. So, the example is given just like fire is localized in a place, but the heat and light is expanded. The vivid example, we can see the sun globe is situated in one place, every one of us we can see, and the heat and light is distributed throughout the whole universe. According to our Vedic conception, the sun is moving around. Not the sun is the center. It is in the center of the universe, but it is going down. Kalachak. It is called Kalachak. In Brahma Sangita, it is said, Jatchakshuresha savita sagala grahana raja samastha suramurti asesa teja jasyagvaya bhravati sanghita kala chakra govindamadi purisham tamaham. From Bhagavatam we understand sun is not fixed up in one place, but it is going round. And the whole universal planetary system, they are also moving, making the pole star. So, making the pole star as the pylon. So, we can see the sun is in the center of the universe, but it is illuminating and heating the whole universe. Similarly, Krishna is situated in his own abode, Goloka Vrindavan, but by distribution of his different energies, he is all pervading. This is the idea. When you speak God all pervading, but he is energy, but he is not different from his energy. Shakti, Shaktimata, Abheda. Shaktiman, the energetic and the energy, they are not different. In the Bhagavad Gita also it is said, Krishna says, Maya tadamidam sadvam jagat abhaktam murtina. I am situated all over the universe in my abhakta form, non-manifested form. The manifested form is Krishna, that is in Goloka Vrindavan. Parasya Shakti Vividhaiva Sriyate. He is distributed all over the universe, everywhere, annantarasam paramanuchayantarasam. He is within the universe, annantarasam, and paramanuchayantarasam, within the atom also. that is all pervading. Sadvam khalidam brahma. So this is to be understood. The God is simultaneously localized and all-pervading. The Mayavadi philosophers, they think materially that if God is all-pervading, why he should be localized? Why he should not be? That is the answer. God is not under your dictation. he is all-powerful, he can do so. Remaining in his own place, he can be distributed. He can distribute himself everywhere. Annantarasam paramanuchayat Advaita yachyati anadi anantarupam Ekapasu rachayatum jagadanna koti Jachakti rasti jagadanna chayajadantam Annantarasam paramanuchayat Govindamadi purusham tamangu. This is the conception of all purpose. So, ekadeśa-sita-śyāgne jūśnā-viśyārini yathā parasa-brahmana-śakti. So we should understand presence of God everywhere by His energy, parasa-brahmana-śakti, tathedam-akilam-jagat. There are many places in Bhagavad-gītā, it is also said, अथवा बहुनैतेन किंज्ञातेन तवार्जुन विष्टव्य अहम इदं कृष्णम एकांशेन स्थितो जगत एकांशेन स्थित एज परमात्मा इज सिचुएटेड एवरीवन देन चैतन्य महाप्रभु सेड कृष्णेर स्वाभाविक तीन शक्ति परिणति चित शक्ति जीव शक्ति आर माया शक्ति. So everything is parasya brahmana shakti. Whatever we see, that is manifestation of the Supreme Lord's different energy. The example is the fire and the heat and life. That's all. Heat is the material energy and light is the spiritual energy. Just like when you feel some heat, you can immediately understand there is some fire. And if there is light, you can immediately understand there is fire. The light we can see and heat we can feel. By feeling or seeing, we can understand the existence of God everywhere. This is intelligence. Not that they challenge foolishly, can you show me God? I cannot see God, therefore, no, why you cannot see God? You can feel the presence of God by heat and light. Like light you can see. When there is sunshine, you can see both the light and the heat. So, as it is confirmed in the Vedic literature, we should appreciate the presence of God everywhere by His different energies, exactly like heat and light. So this energy of Krishna, He has called multi-energy. Natasya kajam karanam cha vidyate Natasya sama udikasya disyate parasa shakti vividaiva sriyate sabhaviki jnana balakriyacha. This is Vedic injunction. Natasya kajam karanansi. Krishna, here he is playing on his flute, but his energies are working. Just like a big man, a big business magnate. He is sitting in his room, but his energy is working, big factory is going on. Large amount of profit is coming automatically. See, if it is possible for ordinary human being that is sitting in one place and still things are going on by management of his energy. So why not Krishna, the Supreme Lord? He is sitting in one place. Goloka eva nivasati akhilatma bhuta ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavita bhi stabhi eva nijarupataya kalabhi Goloka eva nivasati, akhila atman kutva. He is situated in his planet, Golok Vrindavan. Still, his energies are going on. The material energy is working. This material world, Krishna says, maya dhakshena prakriti suyate sacharacharam. Under his vigilance, all the laws of material nature is going on. Exactly in time, the sun is rising, the moon is rising. Everything is going on, minutely, very nicely. Prasya shakti, sabhaviki jnana balakriya. It is going so nicely that Krishna hasn't got to learn how to do it. The machine is so perfect, it is going on perfectly. The flower is coming by his energy. Punna gandha prithivyancha. The special seed you sow on the ground and a particular type of plant will come out. Then rose will come out, a particular flavor will come out. Savabhiki jnana balakriya. We do not see how Krishna's energies are working. But it is working. Don't think that it is automatically there was a chunk and there was no. Not like that. Everything. But his energy is so perfect. It's like if you want to paint one nice flower, you have to arrange so many things, color and the brass and the painting cloth, and you have to apply your energy, but still it will not come so perfect. But Krishna's energy are so perfect that we see automatically, but there is supervision of Krishna. There is no question of accident. Everything is supervised. But sabhaviki jnana balakriya. We have to do it with our hand to paint a picture of a nice rose flower. But in the nature, the flower is coming out, we see automatically, no, the Krishna's energy is working there. But it is going on so swiftly, so, accurately, that he hasn't got to exert his energy, but it is working automatically. Sābhāviki jñāna valakriya. Whatever knowledge is required, if you have studied, you will find in the petals of the flower, the color exactly is symmetrical, everything. Whatever color is required, it is coming out. We say automatically, no automatically. Sābhāviki jñāna valakriya. The knowledge and the action of Krishna is so perfect, it is coming out. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Krishna is sabhavik, things are sabhavik. Natural, automatically. Inconceivable. We cannot conceive that, how it is working. So, Krishna is sabhavik, tini shakti, parinati, chit shakti, jiva shakti, or maya shakti. So, there are many energies, and all the energies now aggregated, divided into three. One is chit shakti, the material spiritual energy. Another is jiva shakti, the marginal energy. Jiva shakti, we are marginal energy. We are shakti, we are not shaktiman. You must always remember. Jiva bhuta mahabhayo, jayega jhar. Para prakriti, aparayam itastu vidhi me prakriti para. Jiva bhuta. Jiva is para-prakriti. It is prakriti, the other dhyamalakshana. It is not purusha. Purusha is enjoyed. And prakriti is enjoyed, predominated. Prakriti is predominated. And God is predominated. So, all these shaktis are fully under control of the Supreme Personality of God. Maya dhakshena prakriti swate sacharat. In another place, sisti sthiti pralaya sadhana shakti rika chai vajasam bhavanani vibhati durga jasata ichhanurupam api jasata cheshtate sa govindamani bhutam tamam. Every shakti is working under his direction. That is Krishna. Krishna Savavitin Shakti Parinati Chit Shakti Jiva Shakti Aharamaya. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that is the Acharya process. Acharya. Achinati Shastra. One who knows the Shastra Artha. One who has assimilated the Shastra-artha, he is Acharya. So immediately he is giving evidence from Shastra. Vishnu Shakti para prokta Kshetrajna kya tatha para Avidya karma sanganya tritiya sukh Shakti Rishat. He has divided the whole energy of Krishna into three, Chit-Shakti, Jiva-Shakti and Maya-Shakti. So the evidence is quoted from Shastra, Vishnu Puran, that Vishnu-Shakti Parapraktya. Originally, the Krishna's energy is Chit-Shakti. Chit-Shakti is spiritual energy, originally. Everything. Just like the sun and the sun sign originally shining, but when it is covered by cloud, it is not shining. Then within the cloud, the real sun sign is there. So this material energy means it is covered by ignorance. This is the difference between spiritual energy and material energy. There is no two energies. Energy is one. Vishnu Shakti Parapraktya. That is para, spiritual energy. Kshetrajna kya tatha para. Kshetrajna kya tatha para. Kshetrajna means jiva shakti, one who knows kshetra and Kshetrajna. This subject matter is dealt in the 13th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Kshetra, Kshetrajna, Jnana. So when Arjuna inquired, Kshetrajna, Krishna replied, Idam Shariram Kshetram iti abhidhiyat. This body is Kshetra. And one who knows this body, it's like I say, it is my body. Sam Kshetrajna. So here the same Kshetrajna. Kshetrajna kya tathapara. The Jiva Shakti, that is also spiritual. We are all spiritual. And this is our mistake, that I am thinking I am this body. This is ignorance. The whole world is going on under this ignorance, that I am this body. I am this body. Jasyātva buddhi kunapi tithātute caiva gokhara. If we study this verse, that anyone who is under the conception of bodily conception, I am this body, then he is no better than the animal. Caiva gokhara. Go means cow and khara means ass. But this is going on. Behold, the so-called nationalism, nations. So what is this idea of nation? I am American. I am Indian. I am Hindustani. I am Pakistani. Bodily concept. But Shastra rejects immediately. If anyone is under the bodily conception of life, he is Saiva Gokhara. He is no better than any. This is the challenge of the Shastra. So all these so-called nationality, big nations, big races, caste, and so on, what is their position? The position is that all of them are animals, that's all. This is the verdict of this. Saeva Gokhara. Actually, this morning we are talking, one dog sees another dog, he is coming from another neighborhood, he immediately begins to bark. Immigration department. Why you are coming in this neighborhood? All right, you can stay here for 3 days, then you must have to bark. The dog barking. So we have opened so many branches, but the basic principle is Saeva Gokhara. All of them are on the platform of animal consciousness. This is the modern civilization. India was never meant for that. Pandita Samadarshina. And this high culture we have lost now. Pandita Samadarshina. They never distinguish Vidya Vinaya Sampanni, Brahmani, Gavihastani, Suni Cheta Sapati. Because there is no bodily concept of life. This is India's prerogative. But now we are also developing the bodily concept of life and becoming one of the animals. There is no distinction. If one is bodily concept of life, he's no better than animal. It may be the dogs are fighting, that I am dog and you are a different dog. If the man also fights on that same principle, then what is the difference between dog and man? So this can be understood when actually Prahlad Maharaj was surprised when his teacher was teaching him how to deal with enemies. He was surprised, who is enemy? So a Vaishnava has no enemy. Vaishnava is friend. Patitanang pavanebha. Vanchakalpatarubhaschakripasandubhaiva. Patitanang pavanebha. Vaishnavibhva namo. Vaishnava is meant for delivering the patit, the fallen. Fallen means fallen in the bodily conception of God. That is putit. So putitanam pavanam. Krishna's also business is to deliver these fools and rascals in the bodily concept of life. First pointing out that you are not this body. Then knowledge begins. Rather, what is knowledge? If one is under the bodily concept of life, he has no life. And he is parāsakti. But not aparāsakti. The aparāsakti, what is that aparāsakti? Na avidyā karma saṅgā anyā tritiyā sakti viṣyate. This material world means full of avidyā and karma saṅgā. And working hard like hogs and dogs day and night. This is material. Material world means based on ignorance that I am this body and working day and night like hogs and dogs. That is material life. But human life, although we have got this material life, body, we should not be, bewildered. Ahankara vimuratma kartaham iti mannati. Ahankara, taking this body in the concept of ahankara, false ahankara, egotism. I am Indian, I am American, I am this, I am that. This is called ahankara. Vimuratma kartaham iti mannati. And the whole world is doing it. So, if we want to become out of this ignorance, then we have to take to Krishna consciousness. Otherwise, there is no possibility. And if we remain in ignorance, then we shall go on committing sinful activities and entangle ourselves in the karma chakra. Asarnapi klesa dayasa deha. If you don't give up this ignorance, a bodily concept of life, and if you go on continuing this bodily concept of life, then we are becoming entangled in the laws of nature. Karmana daivanatrena jantar deha upavatti. And then we create another situation for another body. And another body means another period of suffering. This is going on. Asannabhi klesade asade. Nasadumanne jatamātmanuye. Atma is Sachidānanda. But on account of being bodily covered, encased in this body, we are suffering. We are suffering. Therefore Krishna says that Tāgatidhikkhasa Bhārata. Bhārata was the son of Bharat dynasty, Bhārata. So, in the material world, the suffering is there. But what is that suffering? Mātrāsparśāsva kumtiya sītasna sukhadukkada. Then, on account of this body, now, in this season, we are feeling heat, therefore the fan is there. But another season, the body is the same, but season has changed. Therefore I will have to cover with hot coat and fan. So this feeling of heat and cold is due to this body. And what is this body? This material body. Therefore all our feelings of happiness and distress, it is due to this body. That we do not know. Therefore, the best solution of miserable condition of life is to stop this material body. Then you become spiritually situated and there is no more contradiction. Mātrāsparśāsva-kaunthiya-sītasna-sukha-dukkha-dā. Āgama-pāyināna-nitya-tāna-tithikha-sabhā. That is advice. We have to do our own business, self-realization. There is tapasya. Tapo-dibbhaṁ-putra-kājena-suddhita-satyā. Existence, to purify the existence, we have to practice tapasya. Not running like cats and dogs here and there. This will not make solution of life. Human life is meant for Pudibbhanga Putraka Jina Suddhita Satya Jasmad Brahma Sukhamanu. This is the process. Mahasseva Dharama Hurvi Mukti. If you want to get out of this entanglement of a distress condition, a material body, then Mahasseva, you associate with Mahatma. And serve him. Mahasseva dharma hurvi mukti. Tamadhyaram josithang sangi sangam. And if you want to enjoy senses, then the path of darkness is there. Tamadhyaram. Then you do not know where you are going. Today you are a human being. Tomorrow, after this body, you may become a plant, a tree, or something else. That is tamadhyaram. We are pushing through darkness, that we should not remain in darkness. Jyotirgama, tamasima, don't remain in darkness, come to the light. So we have got so many books of knowledge giving us light, especially in this age, Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. Take advantage of this and come into the light and make your life successful. This is Krishna Consciousness Movement. Thank you very much.